A lot of the time, when I'm standing in the middle of town square, heralding the graces of recording with OBS Studio and Nvidia InVink encoder, people laugh, throw a few rotten tomatoes, and they ask why would anyone want to deal with OBS's complicated setup, process, and so on, when Nvidia Shadowplay works just fine, with only a few clicks. Well, there's a lot of reasons actually, depending on your needs. Let's dive in right after this.
They're behind us.
Who?
They have an Orisa.
Orisa? Where?
Don't go around the corner.
Huh?
You better don't.
I just see a rock. Oh. Cool. Dude, will you just get a mod mic already? It attaches to any headphone so you can use that good pair that you like, but I'll actually be able to understand your callouts. It also has a mute switch so that I don't hear all those darn conversations with your grandma. We gotta get serious if we're gonna get out of plat. Yeah, just order one tonight. Head on over to antlionaudio.com to learn more and check it out. I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software, linked in the playlist in the video description. Check that if you have any questions. I have hopefully answered all of them by now. And check the introduction video to see how this whole course works and was put together and whew. So don't get me wrong, Nvidia Shadowplay, or Nvidia Share, or GeForce Experience Share is great. It allows you to record gameplay up to 4K 60fps at high bit rates with virtually no performance impact. And it even has a flashback recording option like the Elgato capture cards, where you can record up to the past 20 minutes after they happen. If you just play games and want the ability to quickly and easily share a video clip or screenshot sometimes to share with friends, Shadowplay is perfect. Proceed as you are. But if you intend to actually make videos with a deliberate purpose prior to hitting record, or adding your voice or face with a microphone or webcam, perform video editing, and so on, Shadowplay has some issues. Shadowplay uses special video encoding capabilities of your Nvidia graphics card to record video footage without significantly impacting your game's performance as other options do. But that doesn't always mean it can record at full speed. Frequently, you may run into a situation where Shadowplay has recorded your video to a variable frame rate, meaning that the frame rate of the video file changes throughout the video, instead of remaining constant locked to a 30 or 60 FPS frame rate. When playing it back in most media players or uploading it to social media, this isn't a problem. But many video editing programs don't like VFR, and thus you can end up with major audio desync issues from Shadowplay recorded videos. This can be fixed by re-encoding the video with a program like Handbrake to lock the frame rate. This is a time-wasting, annoying extra step and doesn't sometimes fix the issue. Or if you are not familiar enough with Handbrake, you might end up severely hurting your video's final quality. With OBS Studio, this is not an issue. You can capture, record, and so on using the Nvidia InVink encoder with the same performance benefits, but a locked constant frame rate. No desync. If you do have audio desync issues in OBS, it's due to USB drivers of your webcam, microphone, or something else, not VFR. Cool. Another favorite feature that has me using OBS Studio for almost everything is its ability to record multiple audio tracks. That is to say, you can record a video and have your game audio, microphone input, and so on go to separate audio recordings within the video file. This allows you to edit and balance your levels separately in editing, giving you a much stronger control and a better final audio mix. I have other videos on this subject in the OBS course playlist. This is an extremely important feature to many recording workflows, and only two main programs really utilize it, DxStory and OBS Studio. Nvidia Shadowplay doesn't do this, until recent beta features that still have not been polished out well at all. If you want to record your microphone in Shadowplay, you need to crank down your game volume or system volume and do some test recordings to make sure anyone can hear you in the first place. You don't have a whole lot of control here, and I don't like that. Also, OBS lets you record with a lot higher bit rates with the InVink encoder and even a lossless mode, which you can't do directly within Shadowplay. Again, Shadowplay is great for recording after the fact or just grabbing clips to share online. I still use it regularly, purely to record game footage on the fly. But for direct video content creation, it pales in comparison to what you can do with OBS Studio, and I recommend creators learn the ins and outs of OBS Studio with InVink encoder to get the best video creation experience. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course, where you can learn the ins and outs of OBS Studio, has been helpful for you. If it was, dropkick the like button, subscribe for more awesome tech videos, come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming, say hi in chat, and until next time, I'm Meeples Vox, happy streaming!
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.